Gospel Church, Seoul, Korea, September 5, 2004. Here is the testimony of Pastor Byun of Big Faith Church in Ulsan after reading the book Heaven is So Real. First of all, the fact that Dr. Cho of the Yoido Full Gospel Church has translated the book Heaven is So Real by Chu Thomas is something extraordinary. Who is Dr. Cho? Does he have time for translating books? Just the fact that someone like him read this book 7 times and then translated it may be considered a miracle. Following on Dr. Cho's proactive recommendation, this book has become an all-Korean Christianity's early bestseller. The word early bestseller was found because of this book. I doubt that this record will be broken. Now let's talk about this book. When I read Sister Chu's book, I was shocked and challenged, not necessarily because of her visits to heaven, but because of the witness of her Christian life. Her confession that she has not willingly chosen to make Jesus' heart ache and that she was thinking day and night about Jesus were shock itself. This was my goal, but not my life. It's not about her witness of heaven. Who could tell this kind of awesome testimony? I'm too short to be mentioned. It truly was shocking. I felt ashamed of myself both because of her faith and her spiritual state. As for me, she was like a spiritual giant I could never copy or follow. I thought, that's why Dr. Cho has translated this book. Next, in some circles there are growing discussions about whether this book is biblical or not. Well, let me tell you what I think. I think that this book has truly done and is doing great things that thousands of theologians and preachers are not capable of doing. Do you know why? Jesus was worried and angry because in countries where he had shown most of his powers, no repentance took place. Jesus preached the most at Chorazin, Bethsaida, and Capernaum, and he did a lot of miracles. However, because people didn't repent, all the things Jesus had done raised their penalty. Back then, the problem was that people's hearts were selfish and hard. But today, we preachers have the problems. When you listen to sermons today, you might want to ask whether preachers are interested in asking people to repent and whether they truly want to lead the people to heaven. Yet the book is not just a book of theory. It is also distinguishable from other heaven visits that just satisfy curiosity. This book makes people repent. This book changes people. Through this book, lots of pastors and saints all over the place repent, change, and become new people. And the repentance and changes won't cease. Well then, is there anything that makes the Lord happier? Anything which is more important? The Bible tells us that once a soul repents, heaven celebrates and it brings great joy before God and the angels. In this sense, this book wipes the tears from the Lord. This book makes the Lord smile. Listen carefully. Jesus himself said, "Only he who does the will of the Father will enter the kingdom of heaven." Matthew 7:21. Peter explained the reason why Jesus' second coming is being postponed in 2 Peter 3:8-9. God does not want anyone to perish, but everyone to come to repentance. But so many people who go to church do not live by the word of God, but rather break the laws. So many Christians forget about the importance of repentance and live a sinful life despite them saying that they believe. They are heading to hell. Will these kind of people avoid the downfall because you taught them one more Bible verse? No. It's not about knowledge. It's about repentance. This book makes people to repent. Even at this moment, lots of people are moving away from sins and truly fearing God after reading this book. So people on the way to hell are turning around and joining the way towards heaven. But should we criticize this book as we serve the Lord? No, we should shout hallelujah and praise God. Yes, indeed, this book is not to criticize, but to praise the Lord with a hallelujah. At the end, I'm speaking as a pastor. You still haven't read this book? Read, please read. This book is better than 100 sermons of us pastors. This book will lighten your sight to see the narrow path to heaven and will change your eternal destiny. Hallelujah. Be glory to the Lord. Amen. Amen. Preface. In this book, I will be sharing with you the experiences I have had in heaven with Jesus. From the outset, I want you to understand the circumstances surrounding each of these visits to heaven. A passage from the first letter by the Apostle Paul to the Christians in ancient Corinth will help make this clear. It says, "Behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed, in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible has put on incorruption, and this mortal has put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, Death is swallowed up in victory." 1 Corinthians 15, 51-54. This passage of Scripture refers to the end times, when those who know the Lord will go to be with Him forever. When this happens, we will have to exchange our mortal bodies for incorruptible, heavenly bodies. Every time I have gone to heaven with Jesus, this exchange actually has occurred. God would give me a new body, a body in which I looked remarkably like I did when I was a teenager. Sometimes this transformation would take place at a beach on earth that He escorted me to. Other times, I would be clothed in my incorruptible body in my bedroom at home. People often ask me, "Were your experiences in heaven like visions or dreams, or did you actually go there?" My only response to these questions is that I know I've seen heaven, and I know that heaven is so real. Whether we place my experiences in the category of supernatural dreams, visions, or actual experiences, I will leave to the theologians. All I can say is that they were very real to me. Each time the Lord has visited me, I have been lying on my bed under the total control of the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Just before He visits each time, my earthly body quivers and quakes for at least 20 minutes. I do not understand everything about this, but I know that He is releasing His power into my being. Sometimes these preparatory periods last for a half hour or more. Please don't ask me why this is necessary, because only He knows the reason for each experience. He has simply told me over and over again that He is getting me ready for the ministry He has called me to. Usually when this occurs, my body shakes and my stomach tightens. Deep groans emerge from my spirit and I perspire profusely. I believe the groans are those described by the Apostle Paul. Likewise, the Spirit also helps in our weaknesses, for we do not know what we should pray for as we ought. But the Spirit Himself makes intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. Romans 8:26. I believe the perspiring comes from the heavy anointing of the Lord. The Bible often describes the presence of the Lord in terms of fire, heat, and glory, and now I know what these images mean. I personally have experienced the intense heat of His presence. Usually, these manifestations are followed quickly and suddenly by a tremendous surge within and a pulling, jerking sensation without. Then I see my transformed body with the Lord on the earthly beach. After He takes me to heaven, we always return to the same beach we started from. Whenever and whatever has happened, which I admit I do not fully understand, my earthly body has remained in bed during each of my visits to heaven. During these experiences,